Okay, we're going to go ahead and get started. If we have some more join us, then we'll get everybody caught up. But thank you guys for logging in. I have Stephanie here with me, and this is our final statewide meeting for the school year. I can't believe that it's gone by as fast as it has, but as you guys know, I say that every single month, and it just seems like it has really flown by. It's been crazy kind of for Stephanie and I. We've had a lot of things going on, but I can imagine that whether you're, if you're an advisor or a student, you probably feel the same way because it's just a crazy time of the year. And for our seniors, I know many of you, this is probably about your last week of school. So congratulations. I know you have a lot to be proud of and a lot to look forward to. So thank you guys for everything that you've done this year in tobacco prevention and education and advocacy. I do have a few pictures that I just want to, like I always, brag on your activities that you're doing. And then I have several announcements, including the Activism Award winners this year. And of course, Stephanie has our Trivia Tuesday winners and just a few things to kind of look forward to in the summer. So I want to start with just going over some of our projects that we've seen across the state. If I can get this, there we go. We'll start with Ashdown. I thought this was a very unique idea and a great use of their local resources. And I had mentioned this, I believe, last month, but now since it's actually happened, I have a few pictures that they were able to share with us. But they hosted a presentation for their entire high school on vaping and the effects of vaping and nicotine use. And they used a local physician to come in and do that. So here is their physician talking to the students, but also pictured with their Project Prevent chapter. So again, I just thought this was a very creative way to educate your peers, but also a great way to bring someone in from your community too. We have great resources all over the state. And if you're lucky enough to have someone like this in your community, then that's a wonderful connection to make. Good job, Ashdown. And then Charleston has still been busy, and they have a billboard up now for Be Well. And I know we've discussed this, but just as a reminder, you've probably heard 1-800-QUIT-NOW for years and years and years, and Stamp Out Smoking, but the Arkansas Department of Health is moving into Be Well. And of course, the website and the phone number is here, but we have information on this, and you can find it on the Department of Health's website and a link to it from the Project Prevent website. But Be Well is for tobacco cessation, for quitting tobacco, but it's also helped with managing diabetes or high blood pressure. So I love that Charleston was able to promote that in their community. And they all have their chapter photo there with their billboard that they're so proud. And then, of course, they were recognized in their local paper for their Ready, Set, Record award, along with some of the things that they've been doing throughout their community. And they're working on making Charleston, the city of Charleston, tobacco-free, comprehensive tobacco-free community, too. So, again, great work there. And then more tobacco ingredients demos from Harrison Middle School. And again, this is just a great project that their advisor, Tawana Manning, has all of this information and has all of these products. So if you're in that area, she's a great resource, but we could also share what these ingredients are and how you guys could do this activity maybe next year as well. And then down in Texarkana, Arkansas High School hosted a booth at their Mardi Gras Festival. And I've always said, go where the people are. So whether that's getting the information out at a basketball game or whatever your local events are, it's just so smart to just go where the people are already going to be. So great job, Arkansas High School. And they were doing different activities with kids, but also handing out lots of information. They have a trifold board about Project Prevent and the harmful effects of tobacco and nicotine. So great outreach at the Mardi Gras Festival. And I bet it was fun too. And then Stuttgart High School did something similar, but they did this for their students. And again, has their Stuttgart High School PPYC board with lots of information. And they were able to, again, that peer-to-peer education and talk to students in the high school about vaping and tobacco use and nicotine addiction in general. So they did the Don't Be Uncool and Jewel message. on their little goodies that they handed out. This is just a picture of them working on that. And Stuttgart also got to come and be our guest at the Travelers game last week too. So I don't think I have any pictures in here from the Travelers game, but we had a lot of fun. The first game we had Bruno Payet High School and Blavel Middle School drove all the way down. And then the second game we had Stuttgart there with us too. So I'm gonna mute someone. Okay, gotcha. All right, and then next, Lisa Academy West is at it again, and they had this really neat activity. It was a Jewel fact check activity, and as you can kind of follow it along, they had draw an example of a Jewel, and then how much nicotine is in one Jewel pod, and how does nicotine affect the body, what chemicals are in the pods, and when it's inhaled, what happens, and even when it's exposed to the skin. So I thought this was really creative. And then next, Kirby High School. And I hope that I don't remember the acronym for SINAR, and I don't know if I got this right. I meant to check it before, but I ran out of time. But if you're not familiar with SINAR checks, this is Kirby High School, and they're working with Lindsay Mulkey is with one of their regional prevention providers. So Lindsay recruited students to go around to tobacco retailers where people are selling tobacco products. And these students are all under 18, so they're underage, and they try to buy products underage and find out if the store is actually going to sell it to them or not. So it's a really, really beneficial, and it helps us identify places in Arkansas that are selling to minors. So I love that Kirby was able to help her with that. And Bruno Payet had a great idea. They partnered with Ignite to host a family night centered around Jewel use. So this was their flyer. And from what I hear, the attendance was great. They used the Hidden in Plain Sight theme, but really focusing around Jewel use and the dangers around tobacco and nicotine in general. And then I just got these this morning, so I wanted to throw them in here quickly because Berryville hosted tobacco education for all of their students. And this is a picture of just a handful of their slides here. And they did discuss Jewel use. They used these arrows that was like an up or a down to quiz the students on some facts about tobacco use, kind of like we did at the conference with our True Facts, Fake News paddle cards. So it's a great way to get everybody in the audience involved. And then if you see these cigarette costumes, if you remember again at the conference, Valley View has a set of these that they purchased. And it's just very interactive for the elementary students. And I haven't got to talk to Ms. Atkinson's much about this, but I know that just the suits in general are pretty effective. But in Valley View, you know, if you remember, they had a song and dance and everything that went along with their costumes. So it's an attention getter for sure. So again, we've had a lot of amazing work that's been done this year, and hundreds of activities across the state from all of our chapters. So I'm really proud of you guys. We did put out the application for our Project Prevent Activism Awards a while back, and we had several applicants, and we had some wonderful volunteers that some serve on our advisory committee and some have volunteered with us on different events, but they all work in tobacco control. And they volunteered to score all of the applications. The applications were masked, so they didn't know the student's name or what school they were with or what town they lived in. A couple of them mentioned either their school name or their town, and I was able to block that out so that they were completely anonymously judged. So I'm thankful for those that volunteered, and I will say that the scores were all very similar, so it was they were all judged very similar based on the content. And I want to go ahead and announce those winners. So first, the gold, which is the highest, goes to Madison Huggins from Charleston High School. And if you remember, this is actually a cash prize. So the gold Activism Award is a $500 check. And silver goes to Shelby Newby from Berryville High School, and silver is for $300. And then bronze is Charity Robinson from Valley View High School, which is $200. So I'm really happy to share their essays with you all if you're interested. But also, what I didn't ask on the application is what grade these students are in. I know that they are high school students, but if any of the three of these students are not graduating, then I plan to use their expertise and their leadership somehow in the conference next year. So I'm very proud of them, and as well as the others that did send in their applications. Thank you guys for your activism, and I'm really excited to see what we can do next year, continue to build on this. Okay, Stephanie's here, and I always like to stick her with this because typically we have interesting names. So Stephanie's going to announce our Trivia Tuesday winners from Instagram.
Okay, so it makes us laugh every time because y'all have the most creative username sometimes. But the winners for Trivia Tuesday this month are Who is Dev the Dude? So if anyone knows who Dev is, he has won.
Or she, maybe.
Or she, maybe. Michaela Milligan and Kate Addison 03. So these are the winners this time. You can just email us or reach out to us on our Instagram page. We probably won't do the Trivia Tuesday over the summer just because it would be harder to announce the winners and get them prizes. But we'll start it back up again once school starts. But keep checking the social media and following us and looking at our stories, because I'll come up with something else fun to do, just something a little different from the trivia this summer.
So if you know any of these, or if you are one of these winners, be sure to email Stephanie. And her information will be on the end of today's meeting. But email Stephanie and let her know that you've won, and tell her what school you're with. And she'll need your mailing address so she can send you your prize. Stephanie, about how many do you feel are doing this pretty consistently on Tuesdays?
So when we started out with Trivia Tuesday, there were not very many people that got on and that voted or followed. So we probably started out with like between 20 and 25. And so we've been super excited because our followers have grown throughout the school year. So I'm excited to say that now we probably have close to 90 or so, not necessarily just students, but followers that get on and vote and test their tobacco knowledge on Trivia Tuesday. Every week. So hopefully you're learning something while you're having fun.
And you know, we challenged you guys to get to 500 followers on Instagram, and we're right around 450, which I'm really happy with, because we started in the low 200s about halfway through the school year this year. So that's a great place for you guys to connect with us throughout the summer too. All right. Just a couple of other things. We do have some opportunities for things for you guys to do over the summer. I started last summer trying to recruit a few students, and we had probably 15 to 20 students that joined our advisory committee to evaluate our program. And so we looked at things like our social media, the conference, our statewide meetings, and our other projects like Ready, Set, Record and My Reason to Write. And I just really love getting feedback from students, because this program is yours. And we want it to cater to what interests you, but also what works for you. And I want to continue to get that feedback from you guys. So if you are close to Little Rock, or you feel like you might just want to come to Little Rock on June 26th, we'll have our program evaluation meeting from 10 to noon here at Arkansas Children's Hospital. If you're interested in that, just let me know now. You can email me, or your advisor can email me and let me know, and then I'll connect with you and give you more details. But we will feed you lunch, and we would love to have, again, love to have all of the student feedback that we can get. And then also, something that Project Prevent is not directly involved with, but we have found out that the Truth Initiative, if you're familiar with Truth, I know you've seen the commercials, they are hosting three summits all across the United States, and Little Rock has been chosen for one of their locations. They'll be doing an action summit July 28th through the 30th, And I believe I had mentioned this before, but I'll again forward the email that has all of this information, so that if you are interested, you could attend. The only stipulations is you need to be between 14 and 18 years old before July 1st of this year. So that's the age group that they're looking for. So that might be something that that interests you. And again, I'll send out all of those details as well. So when you come back, and I know that you're not even out of school yet, so you're not thinking about coming back next year, but we are already planning for next year, and we want to go ahead and let you guys save the date for our conference in the fall. It will be October 16th, which is again on a Wednesday. Youth-led Fact Fed is our conference theme, but we'll also have a sub theme, is that what we would call it, Stephanie, sub-theme. That we're not quite ready to announce, but I'm really pretty excited about it. Again, it will be at the 4-H Center that is just outside of Little Rock, the Ferndale 4-H Center. We're looking to limit the conference to grades 7th through 12th because we're planning to do a junior summit for grades 6th and under. We do have a handful of, a couple of elementary schools and a handful of middle schools. So we do have some students as young as fourth grade. And I want to be sure that we're providing, you know, the best outreach and the best education, based on our chapter members' ages and grade level. So if you are one of those rare middle schools that has sixth and seventh grade, then just let me know and we'll decide kind of where you think you might best fit. The Junior Summit doesn't have a date and location yet, but we're looking at a couple of different things, but it will be somewhere within, I want to say just within a week or two from the actual conference. We want to keep them very close together. The purpose of doing the conference kind of in the beginning of the school year is to really get you guys geared up for the year, get you some better ideas for activities, and give you some more tools and things to use throughout the year. So it's almost kind of like a kickoff. So that'll be October 16th. If you're an advisor, go ahead and put that on your calendar and start making plans, because we want to see all of you there next year. And speaking of next year, I do want to say that there are some funding opportunities for next year. The Project Prevent Youth Coalition funds 35 chapters throughout the state. This will be done through a $1,500 mini grant. Part of that goes to the advisor for the stipend, and part of that is for the activity funds. And the letter of intent will be available on Monday, May 6th. So you can contact me, but I'll also just be sending that out to several contacts. I know that we have a handful of chapters that have formed this current school year that have been doing things that just are not receiving any funding at all and are interested in getting that next year. So that will be available. The 35 chapters that we have this school year have all had the opportunity to send their letter of intent by the end of this week. So that's why it'll be available for others beginning on Monday. So that's funding just from Project Prevent, but there are also a couple of other partnerships. If you are a SWAG team, the Student Wellness Advocacy Group, that's funding through the Department of Health. And they, I believe, we'll have funding next year, but that is still to be announced. I would love to see them continue. I would love to continue to have that that piece of Project Prevent as well. So I have, if you're not familiar with SWAG or the coordinator, I can connect you with her as soon as I know for sure that they will have funding for next year or if they'll have additional funding. And then I encourage you all to look into other partnerships as well. There are some other groups that may be interested in funding activities or providing you funding to attend the conference or the Ready, Set, Record Film Festival. This could be maybe some other prevention type agencies that work on tobacco, alcohol, and other drugs, or just wellness in general. So if you are kind of looking for some funding, if you want to let me know just kind of what area you're in, I can connect you with some contacts. But a lot of times, you know, you might have a county that has a community foundation or the United Way, that type of thing that may even be interested in funding a chapter as well. So I can help you with any documentation that you need to show what Project Prevent is and what the students would be doing if they provide that. Oh, and I have a message from Tennille at the Tobacco Prevention and Cessation program at the Department of Health. They are in the process of working with funding for the SWAG groups next year. So that looks like that is going to happen. I'm so glad to hear that. Good. So I'll be sharing that information with you guys as soon as I get it. Okay. If you have questions about that, please let me know. I think, I can't believe it, but I think that pretty much wraps up our last meeting of the year. I know it was brief, but we have been, like I said, running around like crazy, and I know you guys have too. I want to be sure that you know that Stephanie and I work year-round and will be here all summer long. If you need us, here's all of our contact information, and we are here to help you if you have training needs throughout the summer. Or anything like that, Stephanie and I would both be happy to come out and speak with your, you know, summer youth groups or anything that you have going on. We would love to help with that. And of course, you can stay connected with us through social media on Facebook, Instagram, and our YouTube channel throughout the year. But we are here, and we will be working all summer long to get ready for next year. I'm going to open it up for questions if anybody has any questions.
Area. Riding, I would hate. I would hate if we had to do a riding on the ACT.
We can hear you guys talking about the ACT. I know where your heads are at. Do you guys have any questions for us? Well, guys, thank you so much for everything that you've done this year, all of the activities and the outreach that you've done. I've seen so much peer-to-peer education. You guys have spent so much time educating your community, as well as your elementary students, which has been very impactful. I couldn't be happier with the growth that we've seen this year, and I couldn't be more excited about what's to come next year. All right. Thank you all so much. Have a great summer.